Welcome to Mind Your Body. I'm Stephanie Stevens. Dr. Marcy Zwelling-Aamot is a quadruple board certified physician in Los Alamitos, California. She specializes in internal medicine in her concierge model practice, where she calls 400 patients her friends and her focus. I get to call her Marcy. Hi, Marcy. Thanks for being here. You know, I've heard you say that we female baby boomers should extend our prime. Even in many ways, Marcy, as our bodies are past their prime, what's my body thinking now at this age?
Really, the genetics is thinking, how can I leave my genetics behind? But we're thinking, as a culture, how can I leave a legacy? Those two don't always mix. So as a baby boomer, what we have to do is we have to intellectualize things a little bit, and we can do that by looking at our genetics and seeing, what's the potential problem here? What do I need to do to extend my prime? It's kind of like if your house needs painting, what kind of paint should I use that'll last for 50 years? Those are the kinds of questions we should be asking our doctors and asking ourselves.
So, how important are our genetics, and do you recommend testing? Because that's quite controversial, right?
Wouldn't it be just an awful thing for a patient to find out they had a risk for breast cancer but didn't know what to do about it? So genetic testing has to be coupled with a physician and a perspective. It doesn't do any good to know that you're going to be in a bad part of town if you don't know to roll up your windows and to protect yourself. So a doctor can help you with all of those things. We have tons of opportunities for people. That's what we do. That's the expertise that we offer. And so genetic testing should not be done really without a professional.
So suppose I know my genetic predispositions. I've heard you tell people, don't wait for the inevitable. What does that mean exactly?
Who expects to live to be 95 and never have anything go wrong? I mean, that's just almost irresponsible thinking. And yet, in our society, we do bone density scans waiting for osteoporosis to happen before we treat it. Foolish, because we know that our bones are going to get less strong. We may not have osteoporosis per se, but to think that our bones are not going to deteriorate over time is foolhardy. So let's protect them. Let's take our calcium, our vitamin D, let's exercise, and if you need a bisphosphonate or estrogen or something else to help, we can do that. We can actually measure bone metabolism. The problem is that in our financially driven healthcare model, the NTX is not a highly reimbursable thing. So doctors are inclined to do testing that's reimbursed. And that's just a sad state about healthcare. We have a system where the financing comes first and the care follows. We need to have care first. You need prevention first and the financing to follow.
I've also heard you tell patients that if they're not feeling well, they shouldn't be embarrassed to call their doctor. That's what you recommend, right?
I think that for some reason, because doctors have, unfortunately, we've put up glass walls between the patient and the reception area. If you call a doctor's office, you get a voicemail, you don't get a real voice. So we've given the wrong impression to patients, when indeed, calling me and letting me take care of the problem de novo right off the bat is so much easier. So I implore patients, you got a question, call your doctor. They don't call you back, find another doctor. It's all about the relationship, someone who has enough respect for you that they will call you back, and someone with whom you respect that you want their answer and you'll call them to find the answer.
Finally, Marcy, what in your opinion is the most exciting medical development for us baby boomers right now?
I think stem cells is really kind of exciting. In fact, it's quite fascinating. So as baby boomers, quite frankly, we were alive the majority of our life when we didn't have a lot of preventive measures available. So there's some things that are just, they are what they are. We've let them go so far. But now we have these things that can rejuvenate us. Holy criminy, that's really cool. So in fact, there's some very not cost prohibitive methodologies where we can get our stem cells done today, we can freeze them, and then as the opportunity comes up, va-voom. So wouldn't it be cool if we could stem cell our hip instead of having a hip replacement, stem cell our pancreas so we don't have to get diabetes? I'd like to stem cell my brain, quite frankly, but I think that that's one of the most important things for baby boomers.
Thanks, Marcy. And thanks for joining us on Mind Your Body. I'm Stephanie Stevens.